guys, it's Jackie and welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I am just sharing with you guys a casual chit chat get ready with me. I'm going to be trying out a bunch of new products, so I'll give you guys kind of my thoughts and first impression on a lot of these products. But I am going to be doing this look right here, which I am so happy with how it turned out. I think it's really soft and romantic and perfect for Valentine's Day. So if you are in need of a look for Valentine's Day, maybe this one might give you some inspiration. And it was super easy to do too, so you don't need to be like a super pro makeup artist to achieve this look. So if you guys are interested in finding out how to get this look and just want to hang out and get ready with me, then just keep on watching. But of course, before we jump into the video, if you are new to my channel, hi, my name is Jackie, or you can call me Jack Jack, whichever you like best. Make sure you hit that red subscribe button and the little bell so you will officially become part of the Little Flower family. Ding! And you won't miss out on any upcoming videos. So with that being said, let's go ahead and jump into the video. So I already went ahead and did my eyebrows and primed my eyelids, so we can go ahead and get started with the eyes. I don't know exactly what I am doing. I just wanted to kind of do a chit chat, get ready with me, and try out a bunch of new products on camera. Some of these will be first impressions and other products I just have never mentioned here on my channel yet. So I just wanted to have fun with some new makeup that I got. So for the eyeshadows, I'm gonna be using the Kylie Cosmetics, the Royal Peach palette. I've had this for a little while now, so I've gotten to play around with it a little bit. And I wanted to create a look for you guys. I'm thinking I want to do something very like soft, appropriate for Valentine's Day. So those of you who did pick this up, you can create a really nice Valentine's Day look. This palette smells disgusting. It smells like spray paint, and I know a lot of people have been complaining about that too. I was watching a bunch of different reviews, and I get it. It's not the actual eyeshadow, it's the packaging that smells. But what is so disappointing is that Kylie has been in the cosmetic world for a little while now, and she knows what she's doing, and she's come out with other eyeshadow palettes that are awesome and don't smell like this. But this palette smells terrible, and like, I don't know, yeah, they kind of upgraded because it's like a bigger palette, there's a mirror and everything, but they downgraded at the same time because it's like they forgot how to make an eyeshadow palette that doesn't smell like spray paint. Like, if it was one or two palettes, no big deal, but everybody's complaining about the smell, and it actually does give me a headache when I'm like sitting here like this doing my makeup. It gives me a headache. It's terrible. Oh, didn't mean to start this video off so negatively, but that's just how I feel about this palette. And I really, oh, I just hit myself. I really love the paper packaging that it comes with. I think the eyes are just so cool and beautiful. I kind of wish it was on here, but I mean, Kylie is the brand, so. But I love the eyes, so that's why I haven't gotten rid of this yet, because I just love, I like this and I like this. I'm gonna go in with this shade right here. I'm gonna use this as my transition color on a big fluffy blending brush. I'm just gonna sweep this into my crease with windshield wiper motions. I always do this, like, especially if I'm doing a look that I'm not quite sure what direction I'm going in. I just kind of like to find the most neutral, matte, light shade in the palette and just use that as my transition and then kind of see where I wanna go from there. I think the eyeshadows are great though. They have great color payoff. They're easy to blend and work with. My only complaint is the packaging. That's it. I did order the Kylie Cosmetics Valentine's Day collection, and the packaging for the Kylie Diary, which is like the, it's like the little eyeshadow palette with some blushes. It looks like similar type of cardboard packaging like this one, so I'm interested to see if that still smells like spray paint. Hopefully not. Hopefully she heard the message that this palette smells absolutely terrible and she's fixed it. Kylie, I feel like it is pretty good. Her and her team are pretty good at listening to what people want. So I'm hopeful that this next palette that I'll be receiving in the mail will smell a lot better. Does not smell like peaches though. You would think, like, if you're competing against Too Faced, the Sweet Peach palette, you'd kind of step it up and maybe make it smell good too, but that's just how I feel. Does not smell delicious like the Too Faced one. It's the exact opposite. It's rare for me to like really, really fall in love with a transition color, but I kind of really love this one. I am thinking I want to, these colors right here, these three at the top are kind of calling my name, so I might stick around there and do something like soft and peachy pink. There's no highlight color in this palette for the brow bone. I'll just use the highlighter that I'm gonna use on my cheek. Okay, on a smaller blending brush. Oh, this is the one from Kylie. This is the one that came in the brush. I'm gonna take this really peachy color right here. Super peachy, super bright too. I'm gonna take that and blend that right into the crease. The brush is not terrible at all. I actually really love these type of blending brushes, so I feel like you can never have enough of these. So I was really excited to get this brush in the palette. That's pretty. It's just so pretty and soft. I really like it so far. I just really wish there was a highlight color in here. That's what's bothering me right now. There's no highlight color. Nothing for the brow bone. You guys, my real question is, when am I going to stop buying from Kylie Cosmetics? When am I going to be over this? I keep getting so excited with all these launches that she does. Like, oh, what the heck? I was talking to one of my girlfriends, and I was like, if every brand kind of promotes their products and their launches the way Kylie does, we'd be in big trouble, because I feel like that's what really gets me. She like does these sneak peeks on Snapchat and social media, and it gets everyone excited, and that's why we keep buying. I actually kind of like, the makeup junkie in me kind of wishes all brands would do that. Too Faced did that with the Sweet Peach. Like, they just kept sneak peeking it and like talking about it, and like when the launch happened, it was huge. I wish more brands did that, did things like that, you know what I mean? Now I'm gonna take this shimmery shade right here. It's kind of like a bronzy pink color. And I'm gonna take that and place that right on my lid. What are your guys' plans for Valentine's Day? Do you have anything planned? Whether or not you have like a significant other, maybe you have plans with your girlfriends, that's always fun. My plans aren't confirmed yet, but I think Johnny and I are going to try to go to Disneyland on Valentine's Day, because the very next day, on the 15th, we actually have concert tickets to see 21 Pilots in Anaheim. So Disneyland is in Anaheim, so it would just kind of make sense for us to go to Disneyland one day and then the next day go to the concert. But again, it's not confirmed yet because we have to see with Johnny's work schedule, but that would be really cool if it happens. I feel like we just need something on the outer corner just to darken it up a little bit. I guess I'll do this one here at the corner. This kind of brownish red color, and it's matte. I'm gonna pick that up on a pencil brush and just work this on the outer V. No, I don't really like how that turned out, but we're just gonna keep going with it. Oh yeah, I really did not. That was not what I was going for. It's okay. It's not the end of the world. Once I put lashes on, because I have little hooded eyes, you won't be able to tell. So it's all good. It's all good. So I have started doing more Instagram videos, like tutorials, like mini tutorials on Instagram. And I really have been enjoying it because I get a lot, you know, I film a lot of videos, and not all of them are makeup tutorials, but sometimes I'll be wearing a look or a hairstyle and people will be like, we want to see a tutorial, and I don't have time in my schedule to also fit that in to the point where it's still relevant, you know what I mean? So that's why I've really been enjoying doing Instagram videos, like tutorials, because it's just really quick, and then if you really do want to see how I got that particular makeup look for that day, I can show that to you on Instagram. I think it's really cool. So now I'm just going to line my eyes with the Too Faced sketch marker, You're So Too Faced. I'm gonna do this off camera real quick and I will be right back. So without even thinking, I already did my mascara and eyelashes as well. For mascara, I use the IT Cosmetics Superhero Mascara. I like using this mascara when I just need something quick. I don't really want to spend time working with the mascara. This does give that chunky kind of look to your lashes, which I know a lot of people may not like, but I I'm a fan of, so that's why I like using this. For my lashes, I use the Ardell Faux Mink Lashes. These are the 810. This is what the box looks like. I believe the Faux Mink Lashes are new to Ardell, and this is what they look like. I think they're just so pretty. They're really comfortable and easy to apply, and I just really been liking them. I really do need to add a highlight to the brow bone though, so I'm actually taking this Black Heart eyeshadow. I got this for Christmas from my little sister Brooklyn. Black Heart is a cosmetic brand that you can find at Hot Topic. So I'm going in, I'm just gonna use the little sponge that it comes with. And I'm gonna take this shade right here and use that as my brow bone highlight. I cannot remember the last time I've used a sponge applicator like this. That's a really pretty highlight. I really, really enjoy that. Can you guys even tell? Probably not, but I really like that highlight. So now moving on to the face, I am going to try the Hourglass Veil Mineral Primer. This has SPF 15. I feel like I've tried a sample of this years ago, but I honestly don't remember my thoughts on it, so this is kind of a first impression. It's so soft. It is very, very soft and silky on the skin. Oh, I like it. Ooh, it feels nice. For foundation, I have a new foundation I'm going to try out, as well as an applicator. I got the Cilla Sponge. Is that what this is called? This was like, it was so talked about not too long ago. And I ordered it when people first started talking about this little guy. I ordered one, but it took nearly 2 months to arrive. So I finally got this and I wanna give it a try. It feels so cool. Oh, it just feels so cool. I'm really excited to give this a try. So I'm gonna use this to apply my foundation, and the foundation I'm gonna use is the Stila Aqua Glow Serum Foundation, and I am in the shade medium. This applicator for this foundation is so cool. So, it has a little pump right here, so you can pump out the product. That's so cool. Okay, let's see what one pump is. Oh, that's a good amount. I mean, I probably am gonna use a little more than that, but we'll see. Okay, I don't really know. Do I go like this and this, or, okay, let's go like this. I'll start on one side. Shoot, I hope this foundation matches me. Oh crap. Okay, let's see. It feels so weird. Okay. Do I smear it? Okay, I put a little too much. Or do I dab it like a beauty blender? I feel like I smear it. That's what feels right to me. Yeah, this doesn't feel like I'm really blending anything. Wow. Okay, I put way too much foundation on my skin. I don't know, you guys. I think this was kind of a gimmicky product. This does not feel like it's really blending well. I feel like I just have a piece of plastic dragging across my skin. That's what it feels like. Wow, I feel like I'm not getting any closer to blending this in. What the heck? I guess this was a shame on me for trying out this product and a new foundation at the same time, because I can't tell if it's the foundation I'm not liking or this applicator. I feel like this applicator though was, I don't know, I'm not digging it right now. As of right now, I feel like nothing is blended in on my face yet. What the heck? Or is it the foundation? Is it the primer? Am I using the wrong side? Is it this side? Are you supposed to use? This is not, oh, this is not going well at all, you guys. Okay, I give up. I'm going to take this product on my hand and see if I can blend this better with my hands. Well, that was interesting. I feel like when I saw other people using this product, they were having a lot better luck than I was. Why? That just looked absolutely terrible on me. What the heck? It feels so cool though. I really wanted to like this. Okay, let's shake this again. Let me grab a foundation brush that I know that I love. Okay, this is the Morphe M439. I am going to put a little bit on my brush and see if I can build the coverage on here. I am gonna have to keep trying this out and get back to you guys on my thoughts because my skin has a lot of texture right now, which, you know, obviously when you're caking on the makeup, you don't really want all that texture because it just looks heavy and it just doesn't look like my skin is smooth. I mean, on camera, it probably looks like my skin is smooth, but looking up close, you can see like so much texture to my skin, and I don't actually have a ton of texture. Like around my nose I do, but it looks like you can see texture everywhere, if that makes sense. I'll have to keep trying out these products because I'm not 100% sure what product is creating that textured look on my skin. I don't know if it's the primer or the foundation. So I'll keep you guys posted. For concealer, I have the Estila Aqua Glow Serum Concealer. So this is from the same collection. This is in light medium. Whoa, it's so watery. Okay, so I can't see what this concealer looks like right now, but it feels really nice. It feels so lightweight, ridiculously lightweight. I don't know, you guys. I'm not sure how I'm feeling about this foundation and concealer combo. But to set my under eyes, I have this powder from e.l.f. You know what? I wish e.l.f. would put the names of their products on the actual packaging, not like the packaging you throw away, on the actual product. I wish they had the names because it only has the color and it's sheer. But this is called like their HD under eye setting powder or something like that. And I wanted to give this a try. Start tapping it under here. I think I really like this powder. Whoa. I was not expecting that to just kind of make everything look so smooth and flawless. Wow. Oh, that's a nice powder. Bravo, e.l.f. Bravo. Wow. Can you guys, I don't know if you can see that on camera. That just smoothed down everything and made it look so nice and flawless. Wow, I really, really like that. Okay, I have some excess that I need to dust off, but I basically set my under eyes. So let me just brush, first close this. Ugh. Let me brush that off with just a brush like this. Now to set the rest of my face, I'm just gonna use the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Pressed Powder. This is in Warm Beige. I've been using this a lot recently and I just really like it. It's kind of like my go-to powder at the moment. So I'm just gonna take this on a gigantic brush like this, kind of swirl that in and pick up the product and then just tap this all over my face. So after setting the foundation, it looks a lot better. Maybe it was just too watery on my skin. You know, I wanted to use this Stila sponge to use the Stila Shape and Shade Custom Contour Duo in Light. So it has a cream, bronzer, and highlight. I wanted to use it together and contour my face, but I don't feel confident using this anymore. I'm just kind of nervous to use this onto my skin. You guys see that, right? That's splotchy. Okay. Yeah, this is definitely a thumbs down. That was such a gimmicky product and I feel stupid for ordering it. But I got to try it out for myself, so now I know. I actually did order another one for you guys, so it will be in an upcoming giveaway video. But yeah, I didn't like it, but whoever wins that giveaway, hopefully they might like it. So now to add some warmth to my skin, I'm going to take this terracotta powder in Mocha Taste from Note Cosmetics. Looks like this, and it is a shimmery bronzer. Oh, a lot of product came on the brush. So this is a shimmery bronzer, so I'm not using this to contour. I'm going to take this very lightly on my brush and just kind of warm up the face. So like the temples, basically the whole perimeter of my face, I'm going to just warm up with this product. Woo, that was way more pigmented than I was expecting. That looks nice. I like that. For blush, I'm going to use the same brush. This is e.l.f. Cosmetics. This is their blush palette. Looks like this. I think I want to take this color right here. It's the more peachy toned color. I'm just going to apply this to the apples of my cheek and blend it back. I think that's pretty and it complements the eyeshadow look really nicely. Now to highlight, I am going to try out the Milani Strobe Light in 01. I'm really excited to try this out. Ooh, hoo, hoo, that's so pretty. This is so, so pretty. A little bit on the tip of my nose. Cupid's bow. It's so subtle, but so beautiful. Oh, I really, really like that. Okay, I think we can go ahead and finish up the eyes underneath. I'm actually gonna take this shimmery kind of copper color right here. It's like a peachy coppery color. But I'm gonna take this color and drag it onto the lower lash line. That is not picking up. I wonder if I need to wet this. Just using my setting spray. Definitely use these shimmer shadows wet for like maximum pigmentation because this is stunning. I have been using this for the longest time. This is the Chella Ivory Lace Highlighter Crayon, and I love using this on the waterline when I want like an open, bright-eyed effect. This is just so pretty. I'm just gonna finish off the bottom lashes with some mascara, and I'm gonna be using the Wet n Wild Lash Renegade for the bottom lashes. Now all that's left is to do the lips, and I want to try out this Skin Fix. This is the Natural Lemon Mint Lip Repair Balm. I guess I should have applied this like before starting this makeup tutorial so I could let it set on my lips before applying the lip product, but we'll just try it out right now. I love lemon. Lemon is one of my favorite scents in the whole wide world. That and lavender. Lemon and lavender, my favorites. Just in case you're wondering, the lip balm did not add color to my lips. That's just foundation. That's foundation on my lips. So for the lips, I'm going to be trying out one of the new lip products from Hourglass Influencer. This color just looks so, so pretty. I'm really excited to try it out. It's so hydrating too. I'm actually really happy with how this look turned out. I'm actually super happy with how this look turned out. It's super soft and romantic, and I think it's perfect for Valentine's Day. I see a hair. I see a hair on my face. Anyways, to finish off, I'm going to try out the Milani Make It Last Setting Spray. I've heard a lot of good things about this, so I've tried it out once. I couldn't really get a feel for it, so I'm gonna try it out again today. Smells like flowers. It has a floral scent to it. I'm so happy with how this look turned out. It's very soft and romantic, and it has like the pink tones for Valentine's Day, but it's still very bronzy. I'm very bronzy. So I hope you guys enjoyed this chit chat get ready with me video. If you liked it, be sure to give it a thumbs up. And I know this was a long video, so if you made it till the end of this video, leave a comment with the secret code word cupcake. Because I really want a cupcake right now. But leave a comment with the word cupcake, and I know that you are a rock star because you made it to the end of this really, really long video. I can't believe you sat through this entire video, but seriously, you guys are rock stars. I love you so, so much. Thank you guys so much for watching. I truly, truly appreciate you for sticking to the end of this video. You guys are just simply amazing, and I love you so, so much, and I cannot wait to see you in my next video. I already miss you guys. I already miss you guys. So don't forget, I upload every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And if you subscribe, make sure you hit the little bell so that way you are notified every time I upload new videos and you won't miss out. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!